never cut tobacco in the hills of Tennessee. I ain't got a moonshine still, but I still love to smoke and drink. No, I never ate dinner from a wood-burning stove. I rode bareback in a rodeo. If you wanna see the redneck side of me, give me a six-string flat-top guitar. Put all you hillbillies in a honky-tonk bar.
Welcome back to the channel. All right. So, it's been a rough week. First week at work, kind of beat my ass being in that heat at the steel mill. But we're back at it. It's Sunday, and we're gonna get you guys a video out tonight. So, first things first, what we're gonna do today is my uncle has a little John Deere lawnmower that needs carburetor rebuild kit. So we got the carburetor rebuild kit in. We got the carburetor. I'm gonna set you guys up on a time lapse, and we're gonna rebuild it. And then we will go from there. Then I'll try to get some video of us putting it back on over at my dad's if he's there. And we'll go from there. So, put you on a time lapse to get the rebuilding this thing.
I put the new forges on the Jeep. I trap until the leather bottoms is underneath. Cause all my homies got it out the street. I keep 100 racks inside my jeans. I remember hitting the mall with my whole team.
We're back. All right, so you guys just watched me take this thing apart and put it back together. All right, so good thing they give us an extra one, but anyways, here it is. It's all back together. Now we're gonna go and put it back on my uncle's lawnmower, just literally right across down at my dad's house. And I'll see if I can get some video of me putting it back together and then of me running it around, testing it. So, but hopefully this fixes it. If not, we're going to have to do some more parts ordering and stuff like that. So, we shall see. But, we'll catch you when we get over there. Welcome back to the channel. So, what we're going to do today is, I had a couple days off from work, and we are working on the Tundra. The horn don't work, so I think it's the switch inside behind the airbag, so we're going to take it apart. I've already kind of started taking it apart, but I had a T30, and then we're going to go over and just, you know what I'm saying? But I got to dig in here and get my T30s out. So, I'm going to get all this stuff up and out of the way so I can even make it to it. I still ain't put my tools away from. Speaking of, this is going to be an add-on video, so I really don't know why I said welcome back. But, oh well, it'll be alright. So, what I did is I made a video about rebuilding a carburetor for my uncle's lawnmower. And it really wasn't that long, so I'm adding this to it. So, let me set you guys up here so you can watch. All right, so what we're doing right now is we are taking these T30s out of the side over here. All they are like some little keepers. Hopefully the airbag doesn't explode on me. That'd be fucking terrible. Now, this should come right out like that. All So when you push it down, I'm sure to activate. I'm all over my head on this one. I gotta look at the manual thing real quick. I'll be right back. So, I just looked up how much this clock spring's gonna be for this horn to work in this truck, and it is $360 at O'Reilly's. We're not doing it. No, we're just gonna have to live without a horn until I'll try to find like a parts truck or something. Somebody's like, hey, I'm trying to get rid of this truck, it's wrecked or whatever. Like, hey, let me get the clock spring out of that thing. But yeah, it's a bit outrageous for a piece of just for the horn to work. Put the damn horn back together. I rolled the window out. Beep, beep. Or hit him with a hong hong or a little toot toot. But yeah, so that plan right there was a bust a latte. So I tried. It's not going to work. Apparently, it's a very common problem in these tundras for the clock spring to go out. But I'm not willing to spend $360 for it. I mean, it's a bit outrageous if you ask me for an airbag clock spring. It's probably why the airbag light's on. It's because this airbag doesn't even work anyways. Alright, that's back on. Nice and toit. Toit like a toya. Let's put this gizmo back together if I can figure out how it goes. Goes something like that, I think. Yep. And let's put the other one. My fat ass can reach it. Put the other one back in. Yeah, that right there. If you ever are going to buy a new truck, just a new truck, not even like new, but a beater truck or, you know, a little riding around truck, and you see one of these come available, don't buy it. Great truck. Everything on it's expensive as hell. I love my little Tundra. It's great. It's, you know, it's a beaut. It's been good to me. I mean, it has, well, the battery disconnect right now, but it's got 240,000 miles on it, and she's still running strong. But every piece and part on this thing is expensive as all get out. And then to top it all off, talk about expensive. You know, I bought Kim, my wife, a new washer and dryer in October of last year. The dryer, you open the door, you know, you got that little, what's that thing called? Anybody know what that thing's called inside that turns it? The cylinder, the casing, whatever it's called. Yep, it's broke. Like, it cracked all the way around the side of it and broke. So when you crank, when you crank up the washer and it goes to doing its tumbling thing, it goes around, it's like, doo-doo, doo-doo, doo-doo. It's bad. So I had to call GE to have them send somebody out here to work on it for our warranty, to replace that whole little canister tub thing, which is bad because they're gonna come out and look at it and be like, oh, well, we got to order this part. Then I'm gonna have to wait 6 months for them to get the part back to me. So, you know, we're gonna be all out of dryer. So if they come out this week and they're like, oh, it's gonna be 6 months, I'm just gonna go buy a new fucking dryer. So that's my thing's been. So sorry, this is a boring video. But I did rebuild a carburetor. That was good news. It ran good. I just got over and totally forgot the video us running it. I did explain in the video before I got the new job at Big River Steel. So making good money now. So y'all know what that means. Is gonna have to get old DJ paid off and get the old race car here. So that'll be coming at some point this year. But I have today, tomorrow off, and I go back in Wednesday night. So that means we're gonna have us a yard cutting video. Oh, I'm thinking about trying to leave it where, like, pretty much where it's at, like bumping my lawnmower up and putting 55T in the center of my yard. see how that works out. But no, right now I think I'm going to go TikTok live for a little while. See if I can't, you know, gather me up some shit. Drink me a few Bush lattes, go TikTok live. Cause I need to stay up because I'm transferring into nights. So they might go in and get me another old Red Bull. Doing me some TikTok live and gonna try to sleep all day tomorrow. Feel like I might save that for tomorrow. Sleep all day, stay, you know, go to bed tonight and stay up all night tomorrow night. Sleep all day, then go to work. Sounds like a fucking plan. But I'm gonna go ahead and edit this video. Sorry, there's nothing really interesting happening over here, but told you guys I was going to get better about uploading, and I'm going to upload pretty much anything and everything that I can, and go from there. So, make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, and Ryan, don't talk shit about my X300. My X300 will tug your little tractor mower all around, okay? And if it won't, I know the old Craftsman will. So, don't play with me, son. Don't play with me. Don't be mad at me because my mower got cruise control and I can sit there and shit my lattes. I ain't got to worry about it. I set the cruise but, and just go. But, Brian, I have an idea. Since you got so many lawn mowers out there, I'll turn my Craftsman into... Let's do a mower build-off. Something. We can race mowers. We'll meet somewhere neutral. Build some mowers up, meet somewhere neutral, and just... We'll do the best 2 out of 3. We'll do 3 different things. We'll drag race, circle race, and then we'll do a tug of war. I ain't got time for that, but if I did, that would be cool. I think that'd be a cool little thing to do. So, but unless you guys like, comment, subscribe, and we will see you in the next one. which will probably be a yard video. Yeah, I think it's going to be a yard video. And we'll try to go from there. So, catch you in the next one. And let's get this thing rolling.